Well, we're essentially saying three things. There has to be an awareness of the problem, a much deeper awareness than what's already there. There has to be support for schools who are doing a lot of work in this area, but an even greater level of support and backup support for schools, and indeed for teachers, both teachers who are taking regular CPD courses, continuous professional development, to bring to them the most up-to-date information about the phenomenon of bullying in general and cyberbullying in particular.
The issue of cyberbullying definitely has made the whole field that much more complex. So now a young person who might be LGBT might be getting bullied in school and then get bullied on the way home from school and then go home and go online and experience the bullying there as well. So I think the kind of advent of cyberbullying has meant that very many LGBT young people feel that it's very hard to get away from it.
The internet's incredibly important for young people and access to it, but you're warning young people as well, you're educating them that there are dangers about putting up photographs, inappropriate photographs can very quickly go all around the world, for example, you know, very totally upsetting and shaming for people, for young people. This is happening, and Scotland Yard would tell me this is a big problem, and our own Gardaí would tell us. So it's about explaining to young people the dangers of internet bullying and their privacy, and being aware that their privacy matters.
Some of the actions that are in today's action plan I think are going to be really important. There's actions around the inspectorate inspecting schools, specifically around homophobic bullying. There's new guidelines for schools that include homophobic bullying in them. And then also, of course, the department is committed to resourcing the Stand Up, Don't Stand for Homophobic Bullying campaign, which will be a huge advance, I think, in helping schools to tackle homophobic bullying.
And the guidelines are very clear that bullying can be a serious child protection issue. Schools don't need to refer every situation, obviously. They deal with many of them themselves. But just to know that there are times when it's appropriate, that it is seen as a child protection issue demanding action. So that's the first issue. But what's important about today is that it's a national action plan for the first time. It's very clear, the report, about what needs to happen in schools, but equally how schools need to link outside the school setting and be aware that what can happen to children in other settings. And therefore schools need to work with, for example, youth clubs as well. And just, you know, the linkages are important between the different places where children are, because we need to interrupt bullying in every setting, including the home.
The action plan sets out the various things that we want to do. We're going to work now to put flesh on that action plan so that we'll have a very clear programme and a set of guidelines for schools to start to implement for the next academic year, starting in September of this year.
Well, the next step is to, as far as this report is concerned, is Minister Quinn is going to set up an implementation group. My Department of Children and Youth Affairs, will be part of that, and we'll be taking forward the recommendations and implementing these 12 recommendations in the coming years.